Hello! Entered into this match that are already it's known they're gonna be here. Oh, but he catches them in a DDT, and that will put you right to sleep. Oh my goodness, now all he has to do is throw him over the top, but I don't know if he has any other plans. Cody slowly getting up. Like I said, that DDT will put you down and kill you. Oh, he's got the snake. Yeah, he's definitely not finished. He's gonna make Cody pay for, being entrant number one, I guess. But now tripping him on the ropes. He's on the ropes. And a big kick, and he is out. Jake the Snake being eliminated quite fast. And Cody has a mic. What does he have to say? That is true. 8 participants left. And who is it going to be? You got to wonder. I don't know who it's going to be, but I am excited to see. And it can be, I think John Morrison is entered in this match. I don't know for sure. Yeah, he's entered in this match. Oh, it's Kofi Kingston! And he gets a DDT by Trick the Snake. And Cody using that rule, you can only go over the top rope to get eliminated. Going under the bottom rope, and oh, what a big drop kick, and Kofi, he's coming in, and a big kick, and now a Pele kick, though, by Cody Rhodes. And, oh, he catches him with a kick! And all his feet almost touch the ground, they're dangling there. He is holding on, but back onto the apron. But oh, he almost got eliminated. Doing a handstand, and he is back in. And he's jumping onto the barricade. And Cody just acting like he has a watch. Acting like he really gives a crap about Cody. I mean, about Kofi. And a Superman punch catches Kofi. And now a nice kip up by Cody Rhodes. Now what is he setting up for? I guess nothing. I thought he was. What's he doing? Oh my god, that big elbow drop into the back of the skull. And now send him on the ropes and trying to throw him out. Well, 1 foot dangling quite close, and oh, he misses and hits the ring apron, and oh, a big splash. And Cody using that rule once again under the bottom rope. But here is Bret the Hitman Hart. And this man is the king of the sharpshooter, and he will make you, oh god, he will make you submit. And a DDT just rolled into a DDT. And now, like I was saying earlier, the sharpshooter, he's got it locked in on Kofi Kingston. And Kofi, he can't tap. If he taps, I don't do anything. Oh my god, it looks like he's trying to make it so they're immobile and then he can just throw them over the top rope. And that is a great strategy by Bret the Hitman Hart here. Man, Kofi has to be in so much pain and now finally letting off with another spear to Cody. And now he's got him in a sharpshooter. And like I said, the pain that has to hurt. And I don't know why Cody put the steps in the ring, but I'm sure that that will come in handy for Cody sometime later on in this match if he don't get eliminated soon, at least. But oh my god, if I was right about his strategy, that would be great for him. But the lights are out, and here's the Undertaker with a new look. And you remember, Undertaker and Cody Rhodes used to be in Indy Inc. So I don't know what's happening. Oh, taking the hat off, and the lights have to flicker, I guess, because dramatic. Oh, but he got him. He's choking him out. And now what's he looking for? Choke slam to the outside of the ring, and he's eliminated. And now it's Bret Hart stomping a mud hole on Cody Rhodes. Oh, and a big boot to the face of Bret the Hitman Hart. And he is not eliminated, but Cody staring off against his former teammate. Oh, he goes for a kick, but he caught him. He caught him in a tombstone. Cody getting what he deserves for being a stuck-up little piece of crap. And now Bret Hart, he's got it locked in. Oh my god, the legs of Cody have to be in so much pain. Oh my god, that has to hurt so bad. Jesus. And he has to be immobile sometime soon. But here is Roman Reigns. Roman Reigns and The Undertaker, two huge participants here. Oh no, he's in the corner with Bret Hart just staring down at Cody. Oh, an uppercut, and now an elbow, and now a big boot, and just laying in with those boots. Jesus. Gosh. Oh, but looks like there's a rope missing. Oh my goodness, look at that staircase where it is. A rope is not there anymore. And Bret Hart eliminates Roman Reigns, and he'll. Oh my god! A last ride. And Cody has to be in pain. Oh, he caught him! And he's going for a tombstone onto the steps! Oh my god. The way that that just fit his head on the steps. Oh, that was just terrifying. And now he has to do his little pose thing, I guess. But I don't know why the camera's so blurry. We really need a better camera crew. Oh, but the charismatic enigma, Jeff Hardy, is here. And he is ready for anything that comes in his way, and he's going for a ladder. And Undertaker doesn't look like he gives a crap about the ladder. And I don't know if they have a secret alliance going on, but Jeff is on top. And he may be thinking Swanton Bomb onto Cody Rhodes. Jesus. And now what's he going for? He's going up. Oh, but Bret Hart tries to eliminate him. And he does. Undertaker's eliminated. Oh, and great thinking by Jeff Hardy to do that whisper in the wind. And now Cody in the corner. And he's coming in off of him. Oh my god, with some teamwork by Bret Hart and Cody Rhodes. You gotta wonder, how long will this alliance stand? Because there can only be one winner. And now Cody mocking the Undertaker. But remember, there can only be one winner. So how long can this alliance stand? But here's Buddy Murphy, and he eliminates Bret Hart so easily. And now what does he have? What is he looking to do here? Wait, the Undertaker! He's eliminated! Oh my goodness! And he's taken Cody out for his whatever he did, I guess. And now what the heck? Matthew Hardy, the brother of Jeff Hardy, and a twist of fate, and he falls out of the ring, and looks like Jeff Hardy's alone here. The first time, actually the second time that someone's been alone, because Cody has been alone in the ring, and now Jeff. But I'm excited to see who the next entry will be. It is very soon, and that rhymed. I kind of liked it, actually. It was a nice rhyme. So, who's it gonna be? I guess we'll have to see. Hey, more rhymes. Oh, God. Gosh, jeez. This is gonna take forever. Those arms are gonna get tired soon. Oh, if you watched his debut here, you would know that I do not like this man. He assaulted me. Yeah, get off my announce table, you jerk. I don't mean get on there either, you jerk. Oh, Samoa Joe, thank you. Thank you, Joe. Even though, yeah, just thank you. Oh, and now, oh my goodness, the athleticism on display. I don't like him as a person, but his wrestling, his work, the work he does, the work he puts in, is absolutely great. The athleticism is definitely a great part, and off the ropes, and oh my goodness. Jeff Hardy getting taken out. But now, what is Morrison looking for? Oh my god! And one foot up, remember, that both foot rule, and that top rope rule that Cody has used, well, Cody did use, so gratefully. Oh my god! Oh my goodness, Cody! I mean, not Cody, Ricochet is entering number 10, and we have seen rumors, we have heard the rumors flying around that Ricochet would enter, well not enter, but Ricochet would debut, well not debut, but return, whoops, cannot talk right, and that is on display, three very athletic men and a super kick to Ricochet. That's the only thing slowing him down. And now he's on the top rope and it looks like he's going for a swanton onto Ricochet, but Morrison coming in and thinking on his feet in a whisper in the wind. You can see the ring awareness. He saw him coming. He could hear the footsteps. And he turned it in to a whisper in the wind. Oh my god. Boy, that pile driver. Weird thing and trying to throw him out. Can he get him out? Morrison hanging on. Oh, and Morrison's out. It's down to Jeff and Ricochet. Jeff and Ricochet the last two. Oh, now what is he going for? Oh, he tries to throw the Canadian Destroyer. It does not happen. And Jeff, why is he on the top rope for? No, oh, but he still lands it. Not Ricochet. I mean, Ricochet still lands it, turns it into a powerbomb, and plants Jeff Hardy into the ring mat. And now Jeff not taking any of it, but, and can he shove him out? And he has. Ricochet is entering the Money in the Cage match later tonight, and I'm very excited for that. Oh my goodness. But we will have more matches also here tonight. That was just the first match, and it was absolutely great. And we will also have a Rumble match. To take him out, it looks. And now what is he going for? He's got a sword, but Kevin Owens has a shield and a baseball bat, and he blocks it and he hits him over the skull with that baseball bat, and he just stabbed him in the chest. Wait, what's he putting under his shirt? He had a
Ah!
up at the Intercontinental Championship will be defended, and it is Tommaso Ciampa 1-on-1 against Randy Orton. And this is going to be an absolute freaking destruction filled match. Go to Ringside Collectibles for all your WWE and AEW action figure needs. Looks like we're backstage and Ricochet just having a drink and some food, and what is wrong with 14 Dream just swiping all off the table? The heck, these men are in the Man in the Cage match. No duh. No duh. He'll be what?
I hear voices in my head. They count to me. They understand. They talk to me. You got tools in your religion, all designed to keep you safe. But when rules start getting broken, you start.
Usually see a slower pace Randy Orton, but he looks like he's in a faster pace. This is a different Randy Orton, and maybe more vicious Randy Orton, even though he's known for being vicious. I don't know. But here we go. Oh, RKO straight out of the gates, and not going for a pin. Oh no, don't do it. Oh, that has ended careers. That vicious punt kick, and now stopping a mud hole into the chest of Tommaso Ciampa, otherwise known as Tomato Ciampa, because after this, he's going to be bloody. Oh my goodness gracious. Like I said, blood. And you can see that chest is red, bright red, about to burst with blood. And oh my god, just throwing him into the steps. And now, again, oh, but he go for a suicide dive. You can see the chest is busted open now. But he threw him into the steps, and that is some great outside and inside of the ring awareness there by Randy Orton. And oh, another chop to the chest, just adding insult to injury. Oh my god, he just twisted his ankle, just like Randy got, looks like Ciampa did to Randy. And now at RKO, 1, 2, 3, his ankle is literally the wrong way. Oh my goodness, and Randy showing no mercy, and he has the Intercontinental Championship now, but no mercy. Tommaso Ciampa, his ankle is literally backwards, that is not good. You'll see he's in an ambulance, and you gotta feel for the man. He's definitely not in any type of shape to wrestle. Later on tonight, United States Championship will be defended by CM Punk going 1-on-1 against Shawn Michaels, and this feud is going to hopefully come to a close here tonight. Oh, here are the Usos going 1-on-1 against, not 1-on-1, 2-on-2 against Seth and Mox. But where are they? Wait, Mox paradigm shift to Seth Rollins. What the heck? So there's not gonna be them, but who's it gonna be? Who's it gonna be? I don't know. Better. Pentagon definitely gained some muscle, and I can say the same for Rey Fénix. I'm just in complete shock. And the match hasn't even started yet, but I guess we're gonna get underway now. Anyway, I'm very excited for this. And here we go, locking up. And going for a Hurricane Rana. And oh my goodness! Oh my god, Jesus! Holy, oh, but a big elbow to the face now. And I do not, oh my god. And off the back, Jesus. The athleticism on display of these two superstars. Holy crap. That is brutal on her who ran onto the ropes. And now what is he looking for? Off the top elbow drop onto his head. One, two, three. And that happened. And great, good Jesus on a stick. Rey Mysterio, Hurricanrana, throwing him out of the ring. And what is he doing here? Looks like he just saved them from the attack of Roman Reigns and the Usos. Is it finally next up? I don't know. But it is the United States Championship match. I don't know why this match is being promoted so much. But later tonight is the Money in the Cage match. And actually, I think it's up next. I don't know for sure. It very well may be. It is. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have not seen the structure yet, look at it. Look at the horrific structure that is Money in the Cage. You can only win by getting that Money in the Bank champion. No, the Money in the Bank championship. That Money in the Bank briefcase at the top. And, oh my god, this is absolutely brutal. And the Bullet Club going after Shinsuke Nakamura. If you remember, Adam Cole leaving the ring. But taking a ladder out, and O'Reilly's under it. That's a new member of Undisputed Era. Anyway, if you remember, Shinsuke and Kenny Omega have bad blood after Kenny Omega lost his United States Championship to Shinsuke Nakamura. And now the Undisputed Era going after the Bullet Club. And now, Velveteen Dream climbing the rope that was just recently adds the structure. Oh, and he just fell down. He just fell down, but that rope kept him from not dying. And Ricochet, can he win it right now? Can he win it this early in the match? Can he win it? Black Mass! And Velveteen Dream is just dead. He is not living. And holy crap, Adam Cole. Adam Cole is just falling. About to fall. And the Undisputed Era thinking, well. And he lands on the ladder into the Undisputed Era. Ooh, that is good. But he's pointing at Ricochet. And Ricochet, holy crap, he almost fell. But he caught himself. And now they're all waiting for Ricochet to fall down just in case. Oh my god. But Shinsuke is climbing. He's climbing the cage. And Omega on the other side. These two, like I said, bad blood between them. Now, you gotta wonder, what will they do here? What will they do? They have no choice to do anything. And Ricochet is on the bottom. And Velveteen Dream and AJ Styles. That's five men on that one row, and there's Aleister Black! Holy crap, how is there so many men on that thing? That's almost half the people in the match! Oh, and there's Rusev! Holy crap, look at this! Oh, there's Roger Strong! Adam Cole! Holy crap! And no one's touching the ground! Kyle Riley and Bobby Fish still not touching the ground! What the heck? How was that physically possible? What the heck? Anyway, I don't know why the camera went black for a second there. Anyway, yeah. Kenny Omega, oh my god, he's gonna win it. He's gonna win it. He's gonna win it. Oh no. Shinsuke not letting it happen. And oh, he just fell. Oh my god, that is a long fall. And Shinsuke too! Holy crap, and Andrew, he's slipping and he's dead! Jesus! And everyone falls. Everyone, literally everyone, dead, falling. Adam Cole, and he's telling the crowd that his Adam Cole baby is gonna win it! He's gonna win it! Oh, a fellow to Dream having none of it! And oh my God, Jesus. Now Ricochet and Velveteen Dream squaring off. And what is Oscar thinking up there? But Ricochet, the athleticism on display. Jesus, there's little small buttons there for men to step on. But Ricochet backflipping off of one. And, oh, there's three men hanging on. Oh, God. Oh, it's about to be four? No, it's about to be two. And you can see Kyle Riley. Oh, it's one. It is one. It's Aleister Black. Can Adam Cole win it here? Can he win it here? He's climbing past it. He's, oh my god, that is like 50. That is over 50 feet in the air. That is over 50 feet in the air. That is over 50 feet in the air. Oh, Panama Sunrise from over 50 feet in the air. From the, what is Cody Rhodes doing here? And what the heck is he doing here? Oh, he just fell. Oh my god. Kyle Riley. And I think Cody might be helping Kenny Omega or AJ Styles because they're usually friends. But oh my god, the blood on Adam Cole and just kicked off Cody Rhodes. Oh my goodness. And Kenny won it. Still are, but up next, finally, is United States Championship match, which has been heavily promoted tonight for some reason. And what is he doing here? He's asking if he'll take money instead of doing it, but looks like he's giving it and saying a deal. It's a deal, Jesus. I know I just sputtered it on commentary here. And Omega telling him 10 lashes. 10 lashes, that is gonna hurt. That is gonna be painful. Oh, one. Oh god, that is two. And his back is already starting to get red. Oh, and now blood gushing out of it. And another. And another, and another, and another, and another, and another, and it's time for the 10th! Yeah. Oh, goodness! Kenny Omega, what kind of sadistic mind is that? Oh! Oh god. Oh. John Moxley, as you can see, this is just some of the stuff that happened earlier tonight. And all the NXT are looking at that briefcase. God. He shattered the bone in his elbow. Oh no. Now, is it going to be Kurt Angle? You know, this is a pre-recorded message, so we don't know if it might be Kurt Angle, maybe. Who's it going to be? Who's it going to be?
For he is limitless.
It's gonna be hard to comment to this match. I don't know the name of any of his moves. And what the heck? I've never seen a man that size do that. What the heck? And now Keith Lee. Oh, and another. Oh my god. I've never seen a man do that. A man of that size, at least. Well, don't. What is he doing on top rope? What is he doing up there? Oh my god. This man is athletic as crap. Jesus. Oh my goodness. Holy crap. That is absolutely terrifying. Oh my god. Please don't do it. He's going to kill him. Oh my god. How is this man so athletic? I was not expecting a man of this size to be so athletic. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh, I guess Keith Lee requested this match to be like, so, oh, one, two, three. And I guess he has won the United States Championship and a Outlast Wrestling contract. So, who is going to be their opponents? I guess it's an open challenge. By request of Road Dogg and Billy Gunn, and I guess we're getting this match underway. And Kyle O'Reilly with a dropkick, and now Kuzlik's pinned. One, two, Road Dogg breaks it up, but this tag team work by Road, but not by Road Dogg, but by the Undisputed Era is absolutely great, and now going for a guillotine drop. Oh my god. You can see why it's called the guillotine drop. And a suplex, and now knees to the spine of Road Dogg. One, two. Oh, and he gets him. This is a very fast-paced match so far due to the great tag team work. Oh, and I think he pulled something in his leg. Oh. Oh, but wait. Shawn Michaels is handcuffing Bobby Fish. And oh, my God, a crossroads. Oh, goodness. Can we get a replay of what might have hurt his leg? I think right here whenever he was going for the pedigree. And then Bobby Fish went for the kick. I think he might have extended his leg a little too far and pulled something in it. And he's handcuffed, but a big kick knocking him to the ground. And Bobby Fish rolled him over. One, two. Oh, and a kick out. Oh, Kyle O'Reilly. Oh, oh. Oh, Jesus. He's choking him out with the freaking handcuffs. Oh, my God. And Bobby Fish getting thrown. No, not Bobby Fish. Kyle O'Reilly getting thrown. And Billy Gunn showing off like a jerk. Oh, wait a minute. He's got him. And the way they're all, oh my god, both in submissions. Oh my goodness. And the whole, no, but they tap out. They tap out. We have new tag team champions. Oh my goodness. What a great sight to see. Ladies and gentlemen, next up is an open challenge for the World Heavyweight Championship, and it is Triple H, and as I said, open challenge for it, and I'm excited to see what it's going to be, but I have no idea. Whoops, what the heck was that? Yeah, and then we also have Kane, one-on-one against Finn Balor. Finn Balor won the Royal Rumble this year, and here he will go one-on-one against Kane, and I am very, very excited to see this match go on, and yeah, let's get it.
Time to play the game. Time to play the game.
What's his opponent gonna be? I'm excited to see.
You know me.
World Heavyweight Championship that belongs to Outlast Wrestling Live, and right now it belongs to Triple H. But I don't know how long it's going for. I'm going for a spear, but that's going into the corner, and now it's setting up for a pedigree. Very cocky, and oh my god, he gets planted. One kick out. How did he kick out a pedigree at one? At one, dang it, at one, and a spear. And now he's waiting for him to get up. And he's gone for another! That is two spears in a row. Can we get a third? Can we get a third? Oh no, going for a suplex now. Oh, Jesus! Oh god, and Edge. What is he thinking of? But, oh, a little fast and slamming to the ground. And now going after the ribs. Oh my god, Jesus! Jesus! Jesus Christ! God, his ribs! Definitely have to be in some pain, and now stomping on the ribs. Definitely a target here by Triple H. Targeting the ribs. Trying to make it harder for him to breathe. And trying to make it harder for him to walk and run. Because the cardio, the lungs, yeah. Oh, God, now stomping a muddle on him. And going for a last shot, but he throws him over and slams him onto the ground. And I think that might have been, yeah, you can see there's blood bursting out of his chest. And his chest with his stomach area, tries to get up, but he just falls back down. And Triple H is exposing the ring mat. Now the ring mat with a wood on it. And you can see that he was bleeding over there. His blood was dripping out of his chest. And Triple H is also bleeding. This is not looking good. There's so much blood everywhere. And there's more blood. Oh my god, and there's a puddle of blood right on his face. One near his foot. Oh my god, blood everywhere. These men, once they start bleeding, I think that is it. And I throw him into the ref. What the heck? And you're assuming to the referee. What was that for? And now, oh, he's dragging his face. That is literally, oh my god. That wheel was going and it just, oh my god. One, two, a slow count, but three. One, and I'm not happy about Triple H winning. That was not fair at all whatsoever. And I really wanted to see Edge become world champion once again. Edge was the second ever world champion, and just right here, this is where it really goes downhill. Hits the ref, and then Triple H. This is what, just, God, it was completely fine until that happened. As soon as the ref got hit, that's when it went downhill, and just absolute destruction was wreaked. And, the match hasn't started yet, and you can see the beautiful American flag right above the ring. And now raising the World Championship on takedown. And here we go, Finn Balor, Kane clashing here. Oh, and a big just shoulder tackle there. And now Finn Balor. Oh, a big shotgun dropkick. And now a big kick to the face of Finn Balor, definitely more athletic than usual. Oh, what a big kick! And now, what is he doing here? That's the Undertaker. What's just up his cannon now? What is he looking for? Oh, just dropping him on his chest. Oh, God, that's gonna hurt. Oh no! Oh, a last ride! And his head is busted open. He's put a mask on him for some reason. No, wait, what just happened? What did he just do to get out of it? I didn't see that. Oh wait, I did. Actually, I just think about it for a second. He turned into a leg drop and he got out of it. Oh, but a big 1918. 1, 2, 3, Finn Balor is the new world champion. And can we just get a round of applause? Finn Balor, not retaining, but earning it. He won the Royal Rumble and he went on to win the World Heavyweight Championship here. And just thank you all for watching. Have a good day. Have a good year. See you in the next video.